Well, this is going to be short and sweet because I caught my wife's cold over the weekend, and I had to do a great deal of audio editing to take out the coughing and hacking that I did yesterday. So what I'm going to do today, to preface what I'm going to do, which I have absolutely no idea what I'm going to draw, you just have to take a look, is a review the drawings that I've already done, kind of show them off, and a few equestrian drawings that I did before that. So here they are. Here's yesterday's drawing. I may go into this and work on this side. I think it needs something. Anyway. This is done last week. This is a lined version that I created for the one before that. And then here's the finished version of that one. And this is my Huckleberry Finn drawing. And Wizard's going to Grandma's house. Wizard gets a toothache. The grand finale of the snake people battles, which may come back. Snake people are hard to defeat. Sterling using acupressure to defeat the snake people, making them nearsighted. And then my homage to Frank Frazetta, which this part here is the poses are derived from Frazetta, and this one I made up. I love Frank Frazetta. This is the beginning of the snake battles. Something out of my head. I used to work from photographs, I guess, when I was interested in the beginning of digital, when I was doing digital art, digital printmaking. But I haven't done any video of it. I may not ever. It's my Wizard's lineup. They get in trouble every once in a while. I haven't posted this yet. I may do something back there, redo something. Wizard musician doing a flutey thing. I think this is the first thing I posted. Wizards Falling. Where I'm interested in creating this foreground stuff and then this background stuff. Which all comes out of this is one painting of the Hudson River Valley School of the Oxbow. Maybe this is the first one, I don't know. Anyway, this is Wizard running. I like running poses. This is Wizard's smoking tobacco, Japanese tobacco, as I thought it was. Didn't I know nothing about tobacco? Haven't even seen a cigarette in 25, 30 years. Can't imagine such a thing. Wizard sleeping. They do sleep, you know. Probably with one eye open. You know what's coming at you. Those snake people. And this is the first. I think this is the first one I actually did, which is harks back. Strangely enough, to my old obsession with Picasso comes from my early 20s. This is a direct influence of the Maria Teresa Walter images that Picasso did in the 1930s. My favorite period of Picasso. So, now let's go back in. Let's go into the equestrian stuff. I live in Florida. Gulf Stream's up the road. So is Calder Racetrack. This is done at Calder Racetrack, I believe. This too, from a video that I did of Calder Racetrack. Here's another one. As they're taking them out of the paddocks. Good time to get photographs. So this is another one from derived from a video still that I really lousy little thing I did, but I was able to get enough information from it to do that. This, where did I do this? I don't know. It's probably Gulfstream. This is practice. This is horse training. This little watercolor I did for my classes a couple of years ago, but it's horse related. This guy's got a rope around his arm. This, I'm a totally successful watercolor of a young lady doing her dressage thing. Another one. Another one. And the last one. I had a lot of fun doing these horse things. So there you have it. I'm not going to continue this. I don't know if I'll talk. I don't think I'll talk over the thing. Okay, so keep quacking and coughing. So better to not have to mess with that. Okay, bye-bye. I said in my previous video that I was working from a mindset that was influenced by both by Matisse, Picasso, and also Leonardo. But it's not slavishly connected to any of them. When I was really young and having grown up in a place that didn't have a whole lot of culture and then being exposed to Picasso and Matisse at a time when minimalism and earth art and conceptual art and things like that were actually in the forefront in the big bad wide world out there. I didn't know anything about that stuff. I just knew these guys could draw. Not in your classical way. Picasso and Matisse could draw, but they were like breaking the conventions of drawing. And Picasso had a particular love of Ing, I-N-G-R-E-S, French artist, who was also Degas' favorite artist. And during the late teens and early 20s, Picasso went through a period in which he started drawing in a quasi-classical mode, using mostly pure line portrait drawings and things like that of his friends and his Russian ballerina wife. And these were really quite much, very much had an affinity to the kind of comic book art that I had been doing since I was involved in doing comics at the time. It was no big deal. But I was, you know, I guess what stuck with it might have been a big deal. I was written up in the comics journal in a real small blurb back in the early 80s. And they lamented that I went on and became a printmaker and a painter, but heck, you know, comics was not as big a wonderful world as it is now. Back in the 70s, it was macaroni and cheese every night. For guys in the Midwest, if you wanted to be a comic book artist, oh, that's really funny. Mom and Dad didn't like that idea at all. Anyway. But I was fortunate enough to study with some people who knew how to convey a few ideas about observational drawing. And I worked at it myself. As you go on through the years, you start picking up on things and noticing things, and then just things happen unconsciously. Like this thing right here, sort of unconscious, though I've been doing similar things like this using really hard pencils for a long time. But these are really soft pencils. And so I can erase most of it. I use it like the underpainting that you see in classical art. You look at Leonardo's Adoration of the Magi, an unfinished painting that he did for a convent and then just gave it up. I'm glad he did because it tells us how he was constructing his paintings. And what he was doing, this is the classical way to make painting. Do everything in monochromatic tones, and you fix all the drawing problems, most of them at least, in the underpainting. And then you apply glazes, and that's where you get all the brilliance and stuff like that, the brilliant color and everything like that. That's the Florentine method. So what I'm doing is I'm doing these line drawings and then I'm giving it some value. I'll do a little more plotting along in the early part of this series. If I can get this to turn into something. What these guys are looking at.
soft pencil, dang. Well. Okay, let's try our little magic thing. I like the way this smudges everything around and gives it also a different direction. So it's almost like cross hatching. A different direction for the marks. What you want to leave understated, you can leave understated pretty easily. It also gives you variation. Most of these lines are not terribly far removed from the same pressure I use for all the other marks. But I can mess around with this now. And if you like these drawings, and occasionally somebody comes and looks at them, tell your buddies about them. I'm not using any advertising to spread this around. I don't see any point in doing that. So I need a word of mouth. If you think these are good drawings, put a link on your Facebook page. Ooh. Now, I should do, in the near future, a multi-part drawing in which I take several hours to really develop something. Because these are one-shot, one-sitting drawings. And so, there are certain limitations to them. I guess I could do that. probably the most challenging thing I find is to draw believable hands and fingers. But it's not impossible to do, so people do it all the time. There's some variation to it. You know, you can, you don't have to draw it like it was an anatomy lesson. Yeah, that's not what art's about. Art's about getting some expressive things going on that eventually becomes visual poetry. Cartoon roots. Someone's told me that once you're a cartoonist, you always go back to that kind of line thing. That's okay, because if you look at Rembrandt, sometimes his work looks like what cartooning would be like later on. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that at all. Oh, what the heck. In the postmodern world that we live in, everything exists. Everything in the history of art that's ever been done is being done right now. So what can I do? One of Snow White's elves messing around with our wizard friend. He's got up his sleeve. Start going to work on this old man. More pencils. I wonder if I should change this guy. Stupid. every drawing, you come to a point where you're going, how am I going to fix this? How am I going to develop this so it becomes a real drawing? And I'm getting to the point where I'm having to make some big decisions. How am I going to fix problems that I see here that are starting to tick me off? Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, it's the same landscape every time. I guess you guys are stuck in the same area in the whatever fantasy world I put them in. Can't seem to find their way home. Huh. Went to Grandma's house once, but I guess it didn't stay. Really never been to Grandma. At least where the wolf did.